A one-of-a-kind home in Bel Air, California is claiming the title of the world's largest and America's most expensive residence. The mega mansion, dubbed The One, offers a mind-boggling 105,000 square feet of living space. Today, we take a keen look inside this multi-million residence. So sit back and be sure to watch the whole video. After nearly a decade of design and development work, what is being billed as the world's most expensive home is finally ready for its close-up. Set on a 5-acre parcel in the posh Los Angeles enclave of Bel Air and aptly named The One, the 105,000 square foot property's interiors have remained a closely guarded secret. Until now. In this video, we are going to have an exclusive look at what's inside this record-setting property and the design and aesthetic minds that made it happen. Developer Niall Niamey once had grandeurs of listing his magnum opus, a 105,000 square foot mega mansion known as The One, for upwards of $500 million. Despite hitting the market for $160 million less than originally planned, the palatial estate could still become the most expensive home ever sold in the United States. Aside from its sheer size, this over-the-top abode boasts some of the most jaw-dropping features that will bend the financial decisions of any millionaire. The home wasn't built for a particular client, but rather as a project for owner and developer Niall Niamey, who hired architect Paul McLean and designer Catherine Rotondi to bring his Angeles pad, which they purchased for $88 million in 2017. The One is characterized by clean lines, water features, neutral colors, and unobstructed views. The quarter-mile-long Bel Air manse is the largest in the world, comprising 21 bedrooms, 42 bathrooms, a 30-vehicle showroom, and 5 swimming pools. Extravagant extras include a 4-lane bowling alley, 30-seat movie theater, hair and beauty salon, a 6,000-square-foot principal suite with dual dressing rooms, and a 10,000-square-foot sky deck complete with a putting green. Surrounded on 3 sides by a moat and a 400-foot-long jogging track, the estate appears to float above the city. Furnished with bespoke pieces from showroom inspired by luxury hotel brands, the comfortable but sophisticated interior ties the home together. A collection of art pieces by creative art partners and art angels decorate the home's walls. With its 26-foot high ceilings, the home's main entrance leads to an array of gathering areas with panoramic 360-degree views of the Pacific Ocean, downtown Los Angeles, and the San Gabriel Mountains. The entry area is filled with water, along with a sculpture and bridge. The use of black, white, and gray throughout the home was based on Niamey's desire to have a neutral palette that would allow the landscape and panoramas to shine. Once completed, The One will also go above and beyond the classic amenities of a mega mansion. Residents can curl up with a book in the glass, encased library, or perfect their bowling game at the home's private 4-lane alley. Netflix binges will be taken to the next level in the 40-seat movie theater. The house even hosts its nightlife with an indoor-outdoor nightclub on the premises. One of the estate's most distinguishing features will be the jellyfish room, where tanks of jellyfish replace the walls, illuminated by black lights. Outside, 4 infinity pools will cover the grounds and a moat will circle the entire property. "It will feel like the house is floating on water," Niamey says. "This project felt exciting and simultaneously intimidating," says McLean. But the home's impressive site and his long-standing relationship with Niamey persuaded McLean to not just take on the project, but create something unique and spectacular. And McLean certainly has delivered. Along with Niamey, Rotondi, founder of KFR Design, worked on the interior design to shape distinctive spaces that flow into one another despite the grandness of the house. The master of interior design, Rotondi, created lavish yet surprisingly livable interiors, playing up the enormous scale of the home with oversized art pieces and custom furnishings by Vesta. Meanwhile, the home's color palette, soft textures, and lighting are an ode to the Tom Ford boutique on Rodeo Drive, a favorite of Niamey and McLean. Thanks to a collaboration between creative art partners and art angels, the property features an impressive collection of art, including a butterfly installation by Stephen Wilson on the lower level and a Nicholas Castello custom panel in black and silver in the office. There is also a sizable collection of bespoke furniture pieces from the showroom. Due to recently approved city ordinances, a house of this magnitude will never again be built in Los Angeles, which means the one will truly remain one of a kind. This project has been such a long and educational journey for us all, McLean notes. It was approached with excitement and was thrilling to create, but I don't think any of us realized just how much effort and time it would take to complete the project. Now, it's time to find the perfect buyer for it. Brandon and Rainey Williams of Williams & Williams Estates Group and Aaron Kerman of Compass will share the listing for the one. If it fetches $340 million, the sale will oust Jeff Bezos' recent purchase of the $165 million Warner Estate in Beverly Hills, currently the priciest single-family transaction in California history. It will also shatter the record for the country's highest-priced home ever sold, which is held by hedge fund billionaire Ken Griffin, who snapped up a $238 million New York City penthouse in 2019. When the mansion is completed, he's confident the right buyer will scoop it up. There's a lot of people out there with a lot of money. They want something no one else can have, Niamey says. This is it.